and welcome back to another video of Baby Loving. Yep, that's me. Today's video, I will talk about tampon picks. More specifically about what are tampon picks and the instinct of forming tampon picks and how a human it actually is to be in a tampon pick or to desire a tampon pick.
A big thank you to my Patreon supporters, Arcana Kitten, Carlo Copier, Wolf Denden, Ruffled Griffin, RBA Betrayx, Luca, Kazu, Kira, and Tuat.
First off, what is a Terran Pack? A Terran Pack is a group of Terrans, usually seeing each other as friends or family. You have in real life packs, ERL packs, also known as local packs usually, as well as online packs, usually called international packs because they are usually international packs. Both packs are a lot of fun and the one is not better than the other. Unlike what most people think, a Terran Pack is not limited to only wolves or canines. A Terran pack can also be multi-species, from wolves to cats to dogs to even the mythical Terrans or the other kin like dragons or unicorns. A Terran pack is also not a thing that is only for children or teenagers. While we usually do see mainly packs of 8 years old to 16 or 18 years old, we also see a lot of Terran packs between 16 to 25. And there are also even a few packs out there that are existing out of adults from 25 to 30 to 50 years old. An interesting thing about older Terrans with the desire of some form of Terran pack is that you have something called a warehouse. A warehouse is basically a house filled with Terrans. Usually those are older members of the Terran community, adults of 30 to 50 years old. They'll form a group and hire a house together or buy a house together. This is called a warehouse. Terran packs are also known for their alpha, beta, omega structure. While this isn't necessary for being a Terran pack, so it's not obligation or standard or something, it is often seen within packs. And that is because very long ago we thought that real life wolf packs were existing out of an alpha, beta, omega structure. Recent research around the 2000s, 2010s has proven, however, that wolf packs, real wild wolf packs, do not have an alpha, beta, omega structure at all. It is a family structure. Mom, dad, and pups. However, the research, original research proving the alpha-beta-omega structure was done on wolf packs in captivity. Those wolf packs were often existing out of random wolves that had no blood connection with each other, were not family or anything, which was caused by aggression and dominance because someone has to be a leader, someone has to be the first one who eats. But you can imagine that the first ever Terran wolf packs thought that it was normal for a wolf pack to have an alpha, beta, omega structure, so they just adopted this. Now why do we then still have this alpha, beta, omega structure in Terran packs? I think it's mainly for the funsies, and I will go later into this why this is actually a very human thing to have ranks in a pack, in a group of humans. For example, my pack, the Candlewood Terran pack, does recognize the fact that real wolf packs do not have rankings, but we just feel it's fun to have a certain nickname related to every person based on their qualities and their likes, and also because it's really fun to roleplay with. But it's more of a human thing than an animal thing. In Terran packs, you will also see that there are often certain restrictions. For example, an age restriction, which is usually between 13 and 18 years old. Location restrictions, by example, only Belgian Terrans or only USA Terrans. Multi-packing restrictions, which some packs handle but not all of them, which means that you cannot be in more than one pack at one time. As well as even species restrictions, like only wolves allowed or only felines allowed. Now most of them, packs that are species specific will not call themselves a pack, but rather call themselves, by example, herd or pod or pride. In some packs who are multi-species, prefer to call themselves just a Terran group or a Terran clan even. So usually those restrictions are meant, well, to protect, to form a good group, a legal group. But sometimes they can get really toxic, manipulative, controlling, and often for the cost of their members' health. Now I made a video on this, healthy versus non-healthy Terran packs, and it includes any information you need to be able to see the difference between the two forms of pack, healthy or non-healthy, and things about like if you are in an unhealthy pack, how to handle it, how to inform people. If you are an alpha of an unhealthy pack, how you can try to change things around for the better of the pack and everything. So maybe this video is really helpful. A history behind Terran packs is that the word Terran pack was created ever since about the 90s to the 2005, 2010. And a pack was not based on the Terran types. It was based on the fact that the first ever Terran community was based on Alt the Horus Werewolves, which was a website thing for werewolf fans. And a lot of Terran created Terran terms based on those werewolf interests. Think about aware, which was the first word for Terran. a howl, which is the traditional term to indicate a Terran meetup. And well, yeah, a Terran pack, which is a group of Terrans. Now, a Terran pack actually didn't used to be this common. It used to be very rare and an exception on the rule of Terrans online. Back in the 90s, when the Terran community started on Altar developed, there were nearly no Terran packs around. There were a few, even a few that existed since before the community, so before the word Terran even existed, but people having animalistic experiences, at least started grouping up together because they found this similar interest, similar experience, similar identity. But around 2008-2010, there was this subculture or lifestyle called Teen Werewolves, which started to boom and get a lot of media attention through a Wolfie Blackheart. And very typical about Terran werewolves was their similar interest to Terrans. Think about gear like collars, tails, lenses, fangs, ears, as well as forming packs and doing meetups. A lot of Terrans around 2008-2010 related to this and adapted from this Teen Werewolf thing into the Terran community and started to wear tails, form packs, do howls more often, everything like that. So suddenly the Terran pack thing was really popular and started to really boom. Also because around 2010, the Terran's Order King got better known, the Fur Fandom Saudis and the Terranians who were in the Fur Fandom were like, oh my god, that's me. And everything they learned in the Fur Fandom, like by example wearing tails, was also taken along and also performed in the Terran community. So that explains the boom in Terran packs and Terran gear and everything like that. Now, with this bit of information of what's a Terran pack and what involves a Terran pack, I'd like to go a bit deeper into why being in a Terran pack is an instinct, very human thing, a normal thing. Now, I've done a bit of research all about the human psychology of bonding with each other. Now, I found some very interesting things, things that helped me make the conclusion of that Terran pack are an instinct. The core of this research was that humans are extremely social creatures. They have the extreme tendencies to form groups, to form bonds, to belong somewhere. Even humans who grew up with no social interactions, family, friends, in the wilderness or in war and other severe situations had the extreme urge to form bonds, groups. What was also interesting is that after some researchers looked into the kind of groups people made and how the process behind it, it was seen that humans have the automatic tendency and instinct to create sort of like a hierarchy, a ranking system. Roles started to create itself over the time. Like, we do it kind of unconsciously, pure by instincts. We have the human tendency to just want to categorize things, want to sort things out. But then I went looking into children-specific studies and I was amazed how specific children are in seeking people to belong to. It was seen that children have the extreme instinctual tendency to bond and form groups with anything as close as they are themselves. For example, typical things like same interests, same ages, same hair colors, same genders, same sizes, same skin tones. And the first instinct they have is to try to relate to something that looks like them. With this information added to it, so added to one, humans are very social and have the automatic tendency to form groups. Two, people have the automatic tendency and instinct to form some form of hierarchy, ranking system, categorization and everything. And three, especially children, but also any person, will automatically try to form a group with anything as close to themselves as possible. And conclude is Terrans will try to form groups with other Terrans, and especially if they're younger, if they're children, teenagers. Which explains all the Terran groups. In that way, we can conclude that Terran packs are very normal, very instinctual, something people also maybe need even.
Oof, PD.
La la la.